Hey everyone, if you're building a computer, when it comes to installing NVMe drives, you might have seen that sometimes there are rubber pads. Either they are pre-installed on the motherboard and you can't remove them, other times they're on the motherboard but you can remove them, and then other times the motherboard actually gives you rubber pads and says you might need to use them, which just gets really confusing then. So do you need M.2 rubber pads when installing an NVMe drive? And the short answer is, really, it depends, which I know is an annoying answer, but bear with me because I'll explain everything you need to know. So those rubber pads, some people think they are for thermal reasons. They think that they are thermal pads that actually help cool the underside of the NVMe drive or something like that, but that is not actually the case. They are non-conductive, hence being rubber, and basically they prevent shorts and things like that from, you know, the underside of an NVMe drive actually touching the motherboard. That is a key reason why they exist, and I'll talk about that more in a second. But sometimes the other reason why those rubber pads are needed is to prevent the NVMe drive actually bending, and I can actually see this is slightly bent, so maybe I didn't use rubber pads at one point. Yeah, it is actually slightly bent. Whoops. But basically what can happen is if your motherboard comes with like a heatsink, for example, you actually install this in your motherboard, but that actually places pressure on the NVMe drive. And if you don't have a rubber pad underneath it, what can actually happen is it could bend inwards a little bit. And a little bit of bending on an NVMe drive isn't too bad, as I'm bending it now. Actually, I've straightened out almost, ironically. But basically, a little bit of bending is fine, but you don't want to, you know, have some really heavy-duty M.2 NVMe heatsink and then no rubber pad under it, because it could actually end up bending things a bit too far. But sometimes the motherboard actually comes with rubber pads in the box, and then they say you might need to install them. And in that case, you need to look at your manual to work out whether you do actually need them or not. But usually they exist, as I said, for two reasons. One of them is to prevent, you know, bowing and stuff, you know, too much pressure from the heatsink. But the other reason, as I mentioned earlier, is to prevent shorts. So for example, on the back of this NVMe drive, there's actually circuitry and stuff. You can't completely see it, but it is there. So if I didn't have a rubber pad, what could potentially happen is part of this NVMe drive could potentially hit onto part of the motherboard and then cause a short circuit. That could then either ruin the motherboard or the NVMe drive or both. So you obviously don't want that. So in that case, you would definitely need a rubber pad, and sometimes you need them for single-sided NVMe drives, meaning one which doesn't have, you know, any storage chips on the underside, but sometimes you only need to use them for double-sided ones, so ones with storage chips on both sides, and it gets a bit complicated. It's basically to do with how much width is actually available once you put the motherboard heatsink on and everything else. But basically, if you're in any doubt, you know, do check the manual on your motherboard, or you can just Google it or anything else, but essentially, the rubber pads are, you know, very useful, and often you will need them, especially for the longer 2280 size of M.2 NVMe drives. And that pretty much wraps things up. If you've got any further questions, please let me know down in the comments. And other than that, if you enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more short videos like this. Thanks for watching.